Have you ever had it where you were on a routine, you were doing the exercises, and then you just switched it up a little bit? You just added a new exercise, maybe a little twist to one of the exercises that you were doing. And then all of a sudden you wake up the next morning and you're super sore and you're thinking, oh wow, you want to feel like that all the time. You got sore because you did something new, and that's great, right? But should you be doing new things all the time? The answer is no. In fact, you both want to do the same stuff all the time, and you should be switching it up for maximum gains. And this is gonna be technical, so to keep your attention, I'm going to switch my camera angles to keep your attention going, because it's very important that you know about the two laws of strength training that are called, one, the law of accommodation, and the law of specificity. The law of accommodation states that if you do the same thing all the time, your body will get used to it. That means it will basically no longer create a positive effect. For instance, if you do side raises with your arms straight, palms facing down, and you do that in week one, you're gonna wake up the next morning feeling really sore in your medial delts, which is the side of your shoulders, and you're gonna feel amazing. It's gonna make you wanna do it next week as well. And then you go next week again, you do it, and you feel good, but you wake up the next morning thinking, oh, yeah, well, meh, 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 meh. And then you do it again the week after that, in week three, you do it again, maybe same weight, same way, and then you're like, yeah, no. It doesn't entice me anymore. It's a relationship that has gone stale. So here's what you do. Every 3 weeks, you switch it up. Now, you could just do a whole new exercise, but you could also make those changes a little bit more nuanced. Literally, you can do that exact same side raise, except this time, instead of having your hands facing down, you have your hands facing to the front. That hits a different angle of your shoulders. At the same time, you can do the side raise with more weight, or you can do it the exact same way, but just hold it up first for 5 seconds. Get that muscle pre-fatigued for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then punch out reps. Or you can just simply do it halfway. See, there's a million ways in which you can switch up the exercise. The same thing goes for leg workouts. For instance, for a back squat, one of my favorite ways of doing a back squat is getting that bar really low on your back and doing what's called a low bar squat. So you unrack the bar, your head is already dropped. Take one step back. You're really focused on pushing your knees out, bending over, coming down, and then coming up right here, so your knees don't really come to the front. But if you keep doing it that way, you're going to get way too good at it that it's going to be a breeze. Why not switch it up and get into a front squat instead, where you get under the bar, put the bar on your shoulders right here, and because the weight of the bar is now more forward, you're gonna be able to lean back more, hitting your quads a lot differently, driving it up. Just switching it up from a back squat to a front squat changes the emphasis from your hamstrings and butt more to your quads. So now you know you got to switch it up, right? But the second law of strength training is the law of specificity, which states that any action you do has to be similar in nature in order for your body to actually make progress. Look, law number one and law number two, they conflict each other, right? Because your training should be different enough for your body to not get used to it, but it should also be similar enough that your body can make progress. So how do you do this? Don't worry, I'm gonna tell you right now. Here's how we do it at Straight Up Fitness, and here's how we get results. Here's how it goes. Every 3 weeks, you do the exact same routine. So let's say you work out 4 days a week, right? Let's say you work out Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Saturday. This can be any day, but on that Monday, you do P1, D1, which is basically phase one, day one. Now on that second week, you do that exact same workout, P1, D1. And then that next week, you do that exact same workout. And you do this from Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Saturday. So Wednesday would be P1, D2. Thursday would be P1, D3. Saturday would be P1, D4. See, this way, every 3 week block, you will be doing that exact same workout, those 4 workouts every week, 3 times in a row. So you can get better with your form, you can lift heavier, and you can make progress. Now, after 3 weeks is when you introduce what is called a deload week. And this is where you do something completely opposite of what you were doing before. And this is also a week where I like to give my central nervous system a break. See, if you were doing heavy squats, heavy deadlifts, heavy bench on those previous 3 weeks, this is a week where you would maybe do some gymnastics, or you maybe do a goblet squat instead of a back squat. You don't have any spinal loading, so you give that spine a break and get it ready for the next 3 weeks, which are going to be completely different than your previous 3 weeks. These workouts would be called P2D1, P2D2, P2D3, P2D4. So this is phase two, day one, and you repeat that 3 weeks in a row. Now, before I end this video, I wanna give a quick heads up to all the guys watching this video, because you're just like me. Here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna get on a routine for 3 weeks straight, and it's gonna feel amazing. That first week, you're gonna be sore, you're gonna be tired, and then the second week, you're gonna be good, you're gonna get a little better. Third week, you're gonna be at your peak. Boom! And then, what's gonna happen? It happens to me all the time. You're gonna wanna keep going. And you're gonna go another week on that routine, and then you're gonna do another week, and then you feel so good. And then you just kinda get sidetracked. Before you know it, you're doing that exact same routine for 2 months, maybe even 3 months, even without taking that deload week. So here you are working out 2-3 months in a row without giving your spine a rest. Then you come to your trainer, your doctor, or your chiro, and you ask him or her, why is your lower back hurting? Why are you not seeing gains anymore? What's happening? Why is your sleep affected? Yeah, it's because you're not giving your body a break every 3 weeks. Now, giving your body that break every 3 weeks is gonna allow you to actually lift heavier every 3 weeks. My voice is going up because I'm very passionate about this. So I want you to understand that it is very important to take those deload weeks. And remember, guys, what is the one type of cardio that you should be doing to burn the most amount of calories? That is the cardio that you're not doing right now. What is the best way of lifting weight that you should be doing? It's the way that you're not doing it right now. Constantly have to switch it up. This way, you will make consistent gains all the way until you're 99 years old. Thank you so much for watching. See you guys soon.